Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
The Rebel Love Show. We are a once-a-week broadcast from Manchester, New Hampshire, where we are pro-pot, pro-gun, and pro-coffee. You can find all of our content at rebelloveshow.com. I am Ron Mathias.
And I'm the Rebel Mistress. Did you like how I jumped in there?
Oh, I love
on
that.
Coffee?
Yes.
I was trying to synchronize.
Yeah, that was beautiful, baby. That was beautiful. So we got a shit ton to talk
about.
Much going on. Everything from Uber activism.
Can I just say, we couldn't even remember our week.
Oh my God.
We were just sitting here like, what did we do the other day? And well, something every day.
Every day there's always something going on. If you are on my Facebook at all and you see me post a lot of pictures, don't think it's like, I literally post that stuff so I remember what happened. Because literally, there's always something going on. I'm always taking pictures just so I can remember, you know, going back and seeing what I actually did.
I'm glad you take pictures because I didn't remember. And then you're scrolling back on your Facebook. And I'm like, oh, we had a fun time. I remember that now.
Yeah, I know. Or exactly.
Maybe just too much weed.
You can never have too much weed.
So how was your week? How's your week been? What's new? What's going on?
Well, I want to start off with, I had a boring date. Really boring date. Like, beautiful chick, 19 years old. She seemed awesome. Tattoos, piercings, blah, blah, blah.
Did I see this chick?
Yeah, you did. You didn't think she was that great looking. I thought she was, but whatever. That's
how tall is she?
She was, I want to say she was taller than you, but I mean,
everyone's taller. Don't compare to me. Yeah, no one can be compared to me.
No one can compare to you, baby doll. But she was, honestly, like 5'5", blonde.
Blonde?
Yeah, blonde, blonde chick.
I didn't know she was blonde.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah,
I don't think I see this chick. Short hair, long hair?
Longish hair.
Was she chubby?
She wasn't chubby.
Was
you
she
said
the...
she was chubby. She was not chubby, but she was just boring. Like, just a boring date. Like,
what do you consider chubby?
What do I consider chubby?
Yeah.
It depends on the weight and height. Like,
yeah, that's true. You know, it all
really
depends.
It really depends on the person. Anyways.
I'm trying to figure out why I said she wasn't attractive, because now that you're speaking
it doesn't even matter. At any rate, one thing that like is horrible going on a date that especially like online, not like someone you
how
meet
long
person,
did you talk to her?
I don't know, like a week or so.
Oh, that's good. That's good timing.
Yeah, like anything longer than that, I barely even want to try anymore. It's not worth it. Like,
yeah.
I'm just messaging someone that I'm never gonna see. Like, what's the point? Yeah.
Lazy.
Yeah, I don't. You can't jump like to that night, but you can, you know, if it's within a week or a week or so. I mean, you can go back.
Unless you're a gay guy, then you can jump whenever.
Well, yeah, it's different.
It doesn't
There's
matter.
Different rules that apply. So
I wish I was a gay guy. Next time on Flaming Freedom.
So, anyways, no, like, I always have a problem, and this actually is also the same thing with a lot of normal people I'll meet. Sometimes it's just really hard to relate. Like, uniqueness represents recognizes uniqueness. Like, they don't have to be a voluntarist or anarchist or whatever and be on that level playing field.
They have like a spark.
Yeah, they have a spark of like creativity or awareness or interest, intrigue, something along those lines. And that was just like, it just wasn't there.
Yeah.
Like, she had no like life experiences to bring up in conversation. She had nothing really to talk about at all.
So, like, what do you picture her day being? Just sitting at home watching Golden Girls?
No, probably sitting at home, smoking pot, playing with her dogs. That's about it.
She sounds like me.
Well, there ain't nothing wrong with it. Don't get me wrong. There ain't nothing wrong with smoking, chilling with your dog. Like, that sounds like a good time to me, too, but I think that's all she really does.
Oh, yeah. I like my puppy. Speaking of staying at home, just to tangent off there a little bit, my new career path. So I've been staying at home a lot lately.
Yeah, you have. First off, I am proud of your new career path. Just saying.
Oh, thank you.
I'm looking forward to the fruits of your labor.
Thank
I want
you
to be my sugar mama.
One day. So I'm now narrating audiobooks. So that's something I've been working on for a few weeks now. first one is actually due to come out very soon. I'm very excited about it, and when it's done, I'm going to announce it, then everyone can go download it. But, I mean, unemployment has been great. It has given me a lot of time to focus on other stuff that's just more important. For instance, I'm in a sketch writers group, and we're writing a comedy show for Liberty Forum, which I'm extra super excited about. I even changed. I'm a cover photo activist.
Yeah, you change your cover photo like once a week.
It has to be an important event.
I've changed my cover photo once.
I'm a cover photo
activist.
Like
once. Yeah.
People make those in cover photo like format, so you can put it as your cover.
You know, I've
photo.
Thought about getting on the cover photo bandwagon, but I don't know. It just seems like too much of like, look at me.
Everyone, like, no, what?
Yeah, I mean, it's just like those people that change their profile picture like every day, and you know, just for the likes, just for the funsies, just for the likes. They're just changing their profile picture left and right, just for the likes.
Let's be honest, we're all like whores here,
and on some degree, yes. Otherwise, you wouldn't be on Facebook or whatnot.
But no, I feel like cover photo activism is important because people always look at your cover photo. They can always. That's the first thing they see when they come to your page. Even if they're not going to like it, they always see your cover photo.
I
attention to everybody's cover photo. I'm like, oh, but I wonder what she has. There's some good ones out there. Just saying. You should get into it, babe.
All right. Maybe I'll start.
You can find some really good stuff, I bet.
Maybe I'll limit to like maybe once every couple of months I'll change it up.
Yeah,
or once a shire year, I think is a good enough time to keep changing your cover photo.
Yeah, I feel like that will work. Also, my unemployment, I had more time to focus on my wedding.
Yeah, you went to a bridal shower, right?
A bridal fitting.
Oh, wow.
Which is really crazy because everyone keeps asking me, like, oh, like, why are you, you know, you're going to have a ceremony? And I'm like, yeah, of course. Like, why would I not want to have a party?
Can I jump in there for a second when you're talking about the wedding and whatnot? This thing really pissed me off. I had a conversation with like coworkers. Coworkers come up to me and I was talking about my wedding and the wedding coming up.
Yeah.
And one of them came up to me and she's like, "So I gotta know, is it gonna be a real wedding? Are you really getting married?"
Yeah.
And I'm like, "Yeah, we're really getting married." So she's like, "Oh, so you're gonna get a license and you know have a priest or something like that there?" I'm like, "No, we're not doing that."
Like, but how does that not, I don't know, that does that make it imaginary? Like,
for I know, some apparently people, I don't we're going to have imaginary how... weddings, you know, we're just pretending, to have a ceremony, we're going to pretend to be with each other for the rest of our lives. It's not like we're already together now, living together, like, that's, I guess we're pretending right now, too.
Yeah, everything is just pretend,
unless we don't have it written down on a piece of paper or a contract that's, yeah, and also somehow pay people we've never met. To get a permission slip, person that you
and
love.
Then if you want to leave, then you pay people to get
well,
a permission
then,
slip.
Well, of course, they come back with the swing it right back around, and they go, but you know, what about the taxes? Well, you get tax breaks for being a couple, so like you get
this is gross.
They don't deal as much money.
I hate writing my address on government pieces of paper. Like, I literally hate it. I cringe. It makes me cringe. Just like being in a government building. I don't want them to have any of my information, especially my personal intimate information. Why do they need that? So they can give me a tax break?
Yeah, but well
for money they stole from me?
Babe, they're just trying to build the roads with those tax dollars. You know, they're just trying to build the roads and, you know, somehow, you know, they have some sort of legitimacy there in order to like say that you need to pay them for permission, and you know they'll give you little kickbacks if you do. They'll bribe you. They're gonna bribe you with it. They're gonna give you some of your money back, and maybe we'll help you out in hospitals or other situations. We'll throw our weight around like, yeah, go ahead. They'll write down on a piece of paper, call it a law, to help you out a little bit.
Yeah.
But you're still submitting to their rule. You're still submitting to what they want you to do, and you gotta pay them to do it. You gotta pay them to do that.
Nothing is free.
No,
especially
of course
not. If it's coming from government. Like, nothing is free. But anyway, for my imaginary bridal. Oh, where were you?
Oh, that's right, the bridal. No, yeah. Go forth.
It was great. Everyone was late, running on shower time, as usual.
Sounds like everyone was drunk, too.
Everyone's drunk the whole day, but what else is there? More when we come back.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf.
Didn't really mind.
Rats is a short
book. You didn't mind though? She's really hot and groped you?
Yeah.
Rats. Okay.
She well, groping everybody though. Everybody who tried to undress herself.
That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no.
I will admit that dog is cute. For those you can't really see the dog, or actually can't see the dog at all on the webcam. There he is. He's in the corner. This dog is like tripled in size in like the last month. At this rate, this dog's gonna be like bigger than Anne. Anne's gonna be able. My rebel mistress here is gonna be able to ride this as a horse at some point soon. That's how big this dog's getting. But he is super cute.
Yeah, I want to get him a spike collar. He can be my little slave. You too.
I ain't wearing no collar, babe. You might be my rebel mistress.
About that.
You might go overboard with some shit like you did last night, but. Yeah, I ain't wearing no goddamn collar.
Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Instead of just listening, you can also watch. See the Liberty Radio Network's key New Hampshire-based live shows via our studio cam at cam.lrn.fm. Plus, you'll still be able to listen to the Liberty Radio Network via the cam feed in high quality 24/7, even when there's no live show being produced in our Keene studio. But wait, there's more.
Oh my God.
Wait.
Online.
Listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
A congressman recently revealed that legislation totaling 2,900 pages and involving more than $1 trillion was available to members of Congress for less than 48 hours to study and consider. That's over 60 pages of legislation per hour. Do you think anyone read the entire bill? I'm Jim Babka with DownsizedDC.org. Considerable.
Yeah, he had to find
buried in a 3,200-page, $388 billion bill, which would have empowered committee chairmen or their agents to examine Americans' tax returns. When this horrible provision came to light, no one claimed to know how it got into the bill. One congressman questioned said, I didn't write it, I didn't approve it, I wasn't even consulted. If your attorney represented you this way, he might be disbarred. But this is how Congress represents you every day. That's why DownsizedDC.org has created the Read the Bills Act. You can force Congress to read their bills before they pass them at DownsizedDC.org.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM are, 1, let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM on your social networking profile. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.LRN.FM. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same great prices, and LRN gets a cut.
Right.
Do your online shopping at shop.lrn.fm.
If you want to move to the free state, and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof. I think we've all had enough of that.
Oh my God, babe. Just think about this. You can get like other. Oh. We should like target all these porcupine businesses and say that you'll do a voiceover for them and you'll be played on LRN.
Come on, you know it.
What do you mean no? Hey, what are we coming back with?
You can come back with your bad date if you had some more on it because I interrupted you.
No, I don't really have anything else.
I'm on that. And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, we were talking about my bridal fitting and our imaginary wedding. And basically, I was saying how everyone was drunk, which, I mean, it's the middle of the day. It's a bridal shower. Everyone's barely legal or not legal. Renee came super late, as per usual. And by this time, no one had eaten, and we had only brought champagne. We just got super drunk. And I tried on dresses, and it was really cute, and the lady was asking I met you and I was like Tinder. And then she was like, oh my God, really? There's hope.
I do
she
not.
She was hot too.
Oh, well, you should have asked her out.
And she seems like a rolling. I swear she seemed like she was on.
Well, I guarantee you probably no bride is ask the person like fitting them if they've gone if they want to go out on a date. You should ask her out.
How
hot.
Do you ask people for three? You know,
you just ask him. That's what you got to do. You just ask. You just break the awkwardness. Say, hey.
I've never asked. I've always just initiated.
Oh. Easy for you to do it, though.
Yeah. Only thing I got to do is just get a few people in a room and everyone will be having sex.
Yeah. You're good at that.
I'm very good at that.
You're a genius.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You can. You're good at putting it all together.
Yeah. I do my fair share here. So as talking about threesomes,
the creamy D freedom fiends. So for those listening at home, we have a new, Rebel Love Show commercial. It's on .fm. It's in rotation right now and it features myself and the Rebel Mistress. And, we talk about why you should, listen to this show. Cause it's one of the hippest, coolest, sexiest podcast coming on, man.
Yes, blah, 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 blah. And it's great. And behind that, we had a homage to Freedom
Fiends. Well, yeah, to Freedom Fiends. Yeah, to Freedom Fiends. I'm a huge fan of Freedom Fiends, to be perfectly honest. I was listening to Freedom Fiends, like I think episode 5 or 10, way back in the Nima Vadadi golden days.
I haven't listened to it. I listened to a bit of it once, and I really liked his voice, which is why I really liked his sex tape.
Oh, yeah, it was fantastic.
His voice is really nice.
So, speaking of, in this commercial, we have the creamy, we have Creamy Fiends, Michael Dean. Back in, like, I want to say March, he posted this podcast of him, his wife, and another woman having a threesome as a podcast. It was like some kink podcast he used to do, like, apparently before Freedom Fiends and whatnot. And he commented about how me and Ogro should like have more sex on air or something. Like, I wasn't even with him. I forgot what he exactly said. And I'm not that ended a long time ago or whatever. At any rate, it was like you should have more sex for liberty. Or he said something along those lines. He's like me and
it was awesome. We listened to the sex tape. Amazing. We all liked it.
Yeah, we loved it.
It's been like our just like a running Rebel Love Show.
It was like. I think 51 or 52, we actually critiqued the podcast on air. So we actually played it on air. And we listened to it.
Renee's reaction.
God, Renee's reaction.
Such a
horrible.
Bitch.
Yeah, she was so stuck. Hopefully she's grown up a little bit more without that stuck-upness. Because, man, she actually, like, everything about it was horrible. I thought it was beautiful.
She still would think it was horrible, I bet.
I'm sure she probably would.
But anyway, no, we loved it. And he told us to listen to his show and that he had mixed feelings about
well
it.
See he first off I never told him that I was putting that in a commercial. I didn't tell anyone that, to be perfectly honest, except for a couple people in person, but for the most part I never told anyone that we were going to put sex tape as a backdrop of our commercial. So basically the entire commercial is his sex tape for a minute, our bumper, and then
over
that as well, so it's our music as well from one of our bumpers, and then us I never asked. I figured he'd figure it out. I was kind of hoping to see what his reaction.
Yeah, and I thought he'd be happy, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, there
I
was
thought
a,
he'd think it was funny.
We,
I thought it was funny.
We played it on
funny.
The show before, loved it, yeah. And we wanted to like give it a little boost, like, you know, like we used it on the show before, so it was nothing but flattery, you know, from our perspective.
Yeah, definitely, and we didn't no disrespect at all, and even though we don't believe in IP, like we'd be happy to take it down because I was not. Definitely not trying to disrespect you in any way,
yeah,
or
so,
your wife.
Well, yeah. So
if I was his wife, like, and I was mad about it, I'd understand. But
yeah, well, yeah, he talked about on the previous Freedom Fiends episode about how he had mixed feelings. The wife didn't like it, he kind of. I did want to touch one thing. He did talk about how it was kind of false advertising, somewhat, and said how we should have sex in the background. I do disagree with that because that is content that was on a previous episode. So that's not something that's something that has already been on the show before, and that's just
bringing back
an old episode and reincorporating into a commercial. So I do disagree with you on that. And IP's IP, I can do whatever the fuck I want. But I will if he doesn't like it, To be generous and honorish and whatever you want to say, I will gladly redo it with a different sex tape, probably ours or something like that. But I don't want him to, you know.
No, I don't want anyone to be upset.
Yeah, I don't want him to be upset with it.
But if he says, I mean, I don't know. I'd be glad to take it down. We are planning on making another commercial either way. So.
Yeah, we're going
to,
yeah.
And that one will be extra fun as well. So I look forward to that. And also, he actually said that, what was it exactly? Can't remember word for word, but he was wondering. He called me your girlfriend, which I hate when people do that.
I know you're my fiance. You're gonna be my life partner.
First of
my
all,
life.
I'm your nothing. I am my own person and individual. And I was in this community when me and Rob weren't together. That's all I just would like everyone to remember.
No, you
here.
Stayed even though. Yeah. When we broke up, you still stayed around.
Like that guy's girlfriend. And I had my own show. It's not like I can't even be like the co-host of like, I mean, a host of like, I'm just like that guy's girlfriend. Come on.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, you're co-host of Flaming Freedom. You were the host / co-host of Seditious Sirens. Yeah, you've done a lot of radio as it is on LRN.
Yeah. And I pretty much try to stay active. But anyway, and he's wondering if someone should tell me what a mistress is. And, you know, Creamy D, no one needs to tell me what a mistress is. I feel like I could tell you, I could show you better than I could tell you. So I was wondering if that was a challenge. I'll show you who's your mistress. But other than that.
Trust me, she can. I'm like, I'm still recovering from last night.
I am a lady in the streets and a mistress in the sheets. I have my sweet side and I have my dom side. And, you know, we could talk about that in Flaming Freedom, which is where we get really kinky.
Yeah,
but
no, you don't like talking about too much sex and kink on this show as much as
this
you know Flaming Freedom.
This isn't
if you want to know about
show.
Our sex life, apparently listen to Flaming Freedom because she goes into super detail on that. But
what
she doesn't
can I
like
say
to do it on this show.
It's Derek J's butt cheeks.
His butt cheeks did look fantastic at the Halloween dance
Derek
party.
Derek J is just fabulous. So, yeah. But that's the Sex, Drugs, and Anarchy show. But, you know, never judge a book by its cover. I think that's what I'd say. I really still like your voice. So, I mean, if you want us to take your sex tape down, we will. But just so you know, we meant no disrespect. So we just wanted to point that out. When we come back, talk about my first experience with Star Wars.
Oh my god, guys, it's good.
Why did you move to the
what
Shire?
What are you reading?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around.
What were you reading?
Liberty just as seriously as I do.
I was just curious what you wrote. I saw that you were typing.
People challenging
what?
And thought that
I could get support. Oh, okay.
What I was
okay.
To me, like,
okay. What was it? I know, but it was okay. It was in the show notes, so I figured it was something different.
No, I have the Uber. I just have everything else we talked about.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people. Actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of
but
something important is
so
happening here,
read,
and I just
I
wanted to
read,
come to sort of be part
read.
Of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read
and
sign the Shire
down
Society
down
Declan and
say.
Learn the reasons why. Okay.
And then
liberty,
you didn't, then you said
you
it, so I thought maybe you did
Shire.
See it.
Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Oh, did you delete it?
No, I don't know. I'm just opening, like, this. I don't even think this is in any doc. I just think it's just a blank one.
Oh, then how? Yeah, I didn't know you wrote that.
Yeah, but I didn't realize.
We can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying,
you know, this is a really good commercial.
Demonstrate the power of these ideas.
This commercial for 101 Reasons to Move to New Hampshire, it actually is really well edited.
People are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New
Hampshire.
It has
great production
value. A documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at
101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Look stern.
Yeah.
I really like this purple shirt.
No, I mean in the 101 Reasons video.
I look stern.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That, I looked a hardcore anarchist in that.
You wonder why people don't like it. I'm just kidding.
Look, you know what? I work as a sales job in my day job, and it's one thing I learned relatively quickly is you need to be confident of yourself and what you can do. And there's a thin line between confidence and arrogance. I like to think I walk over that line from time to time, but I'd rather do that than actually, you know, be a pushover and walk over. Like that's just who I am. I don't mean disrespect to other people if I'm come across as a know-it-all or, you know, full of myself or something, but you kind of have to be full of yourself. You got to love you and be passionate about you and be, I mean...
I somewhat.
Somewhat. I may take it too far.
Tone
and
it
I,
down.
Sometimes, I know, to be perfectly honest, I feel like I've toned it down a lot in the last year.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Definitely. It's because I dominate you so hard. You don't have a choice. Well,
yeah,
to
when I let
down.
You, and that's only let you do that because I want you to.
Sure.
I don't really.
Sure. Don't shivers really... and chills. What do you
oh
want me to do?
Oh, that was incredible. You need to do that again.
Shut up. You're so ridiculous.
Like, and I wasn't complaining about it. I thought I loved it.
You weren't.
Actually, I'm a little upset that you stopped. Oh, well, I did say the safe word, so you're right. I shouldn't have said it. I
you
actually regret
so
it.
You talk so much shit.
I regretted it.
You talk
I regretted saying it afterwards.
You talk so much shit. You just talk all of the shit.
All the shit?
All of
it.
Tips for job seekers and making all the other conversations you have more productive. Hit
survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook. What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the show. And right before the break, my real mistress here dropped the bombshell, and this is something I've been trying to get her to do for literally since the moment I met her, well, at least until the moment I found out, which I probably was relatively quickly, and I've been pushing this for a long time, but she's never seen Star Wars. Now, do not be mean about it. Don't judge her for it. I mean, her past history. She was never introduced or experienced. You know, she never had the life experience of watching Star Wars. It saddens me in my heart. You know, I'm a sci-fi geek, and Star Wars is amazing.
You're just such a nerd because like no one I grew up around was watching Star Wars.
Everyone I knew when I was growing up watched Star Wars. Every single person I've ever met until you. Has seen Star Wars.
Well, every single person I've ever met.
They may not have liked Star
you,
Wars, but they've actually seen it.
Well, that's not true. But mostly,
that
yeah.
That is true.
No,
literally.
No, because
you
I
and
was
one other person
are
the only two
wasn't
people I've
true.
Ever met.
Yeah, I was saying what I said wasn't true. No, no one was watching Star Wars. It wasn't a big deal. I don't know what to tell you. But anyway, I did watch it for the first time. It was awesome. It's pretty good. I already knew a lot of the references from that 70s show.
Yeah. But I got to jump in, babe.
Okay.
When you first started watching, I gotta be very specific. I started on episode 4, A New Hope. I figured that's a great start. You gotta start with the classics. You know, you can't just jump to one. I mean, you can't. I don't even think she should even watch one to begin with. All right. But we did episode 4. You know, she saw them defeat the Death Star. And then we went to episode 5, Empire Strikes Back, all right, which is by far, and I hate to break it to you, babe, Empire Strikes Back was by far the best Star Wars film ever made.
It's all downhill from
now. Yeah, it's all downhill. I didn't want to say that to you, but it's all downhill from now.
About the new one? Why are we going to watch that one?
Because I have high hopes for it. Now, here's... We're at a dilemma right now. Do we go just to 6, or just six, or then go back to 1, 2, and 3. That is not the order that she will be watching Star Wars. She will be watching Star Wars going back to 2 and 3. I want to give her the hero's tale of Darth Vader. All right, maybe he wasn't the bad guy that everyone thought he was, and she just found out that Darth Vader, Luke's father. Like, she just found this out.
Yeah, I mean, so this is what I. So now you can judge me.
I had to give the detail of how we're going to be watching him.
So, I knew some of the references from like that 70s show because I used to watch that show and I liked it. And as for movies, like I watched a lot of like Blow. Like, I don't know. Stuff about Johnny Depp. I really like Johnny Depp.
Please don't say that you watched that as a kid. You need to say...
That's what I watched.
I watched that. I wasn't a kid when I watched that.
Harry Potter, like, The Hunger Games, like, I don't know. Anyway, I knew some of the references from, like, that 70s show, and it's like, Luke, I am your father. So, and, of course, it's just a famous... anyway, but what I thought is that he said that and it wasn't true. Like, it may not have been true.
Why did you think that?
Because I know they have mind control over people. So I was like, oh, he's trying to make him think he's his dad because he really killed his dad. So I was like, oh, like that. And then it's just like him the rest of the show trying to figure out if Darth Vader is his father or not. And then it turns out that Darth Vader's not his dad. I don't know. I don't know. That was my imagination for Star Wars, but I was wrong.
So what did you think of it? Like, it everything you thought it would be? Was it better? Was it worse? Like, I mean, this is something that people have talked to probably multiple times in your life.
I never thought anything about it, honestly. I know you want me to.
I'm not asking you what you thought about. Well, like going
in.
No,
I'm saying I didn't have any expectations. You kept telling me don't have any expectations, and I honestly didn't because I never thought about, you know, Star Wars in like this epic fashion. But now I see why people love it. It's like just like Harry Potter and everything else because it has like a tale, a hero's journey, like who's good and who's bad, and I like that concept of morality in shows. And he chopped off that guy's fucking arm, and I was like,
I mean, Luke's.
Luke.
His father.
His father chopped
off his arm.
And I was really disturbed by that because I was like, there was no, like, I never heard anyone say he was handicapped.
She's like turning to me like,
how is he going to go
be an
on
amputee
with no
hand? In the next movie? Like, how are they going to fix this?
So when they chopped his arm off, I kept thinking he was going to mind control it back to him or something and then kill Darth Vader.
She was really shocked by it. She was super shocked.
I don't know. I had high hopes for it. Why do you think everyone loves Star Wars? What is your... Why are you so... fangirl
it's
about
so
it.
Epic. It's such an epic story of
a lot of
libertarian, and,
like every libertarian. Does it have any libertarian?
No, well,
yes.
Oh, Han Solo. I mean, Han Solo is the quintessential anarchist in the movies. I mean, he's all about capitalism. He's all about free trade, and he's like, fuck the state. I want to go help, like, join the military. Like not the military, but join the resistance. I mean, he's a jack of all trades. So I mean, yeah, he's fantastic. But that is a very big libertarian thing in there. The fact that so many libertarians are very anti, like, the empire that is the United States government. So a lot of people can compare the police state and the military to stormtroopers. So there's a lot. You know, the fact that they're rebels, you know, and they're trying to bring freedom to the galaxy.
That makes sense. Oh, okay. I just totally got that. Just now.
That they're fighting an oppressive government.
It's because but it's kind of hard to like put it into perspective because they're like flying all through the universe and they're like, oh, we're going to this galaxy, and, like, light speed and shit. Like, I don't know.
Well, it's one galaxy. It's a galaxy far, far away and a long time ago.
Yeah, so I guess that's why it was hard for me to find a symbolism. I got it. I mean, I see why people love it, and I'm rooting for so many people, and I don't know what's going to happen.
Okay, that's a perfect transition. What are you hoping for, and what do you think is going to happen in six?
In six, I'm hoping that Leia... I didn't know this whole Leia and Hans were, like, hooking up. I didn't know they were, like... And you're so vain about, like, Hans. He's so, like, vain. I don't know.
Yeah, that's why I love Han Solo.
I was hoping Leia would be with Luke. So I'm kind of hoping that happens.
Well,
and
you, okay, all right.
And
fair enough. I kind of
want a love story between Darth Vader and Luke. Like, Yeah, I want them to like
father and son reconnect.
He gives him his arm back. I don't know. He apologizes for chopping it off, and Darth Vader just turns into a good guy. Okay, so we can obviously tell that
Please, people, do not pay for any spoilers. Do not do any kind of spoilers. Cause
well, we've all watched like Game of Thrones and The Red Wedding, and you know we all had high hopes for all of those people, and they just all fucking died. So.
Yeah, I know.
So you never know what's gonna happen in a movie, but I'm excited to keep watching it, and we're gonna have a Chinese and Star Wars party because we're racist.
Yeah, and we hate Chinese people and Star Wars apparently. I don't know.
And Christmas.
Yeah.
We got a racist Starbucks cup the other day.
But the way you're going that you're gonna see this the rest of the Star Wars films are gonna no one to my knowledge is ever, well, I'm sure someone has at some point, but the way you're gonna watch it, you're gonna see the hero's journey of Darth Vader. And the reason why I say that is because I don't really if I had force powers or whatnot, I would not consider myself a Jedi. I would probably consider myself a Sith. Now, would I do as horrible things that Darth Vader has already done? No, I would not. But at the same time, I mean, the Sith, they can still love and they can have fun. You know, they're not so rigid. And in all honesty, like, what did the Jedi Empire, I mean, the Jedi really do in their heyday, which you haven't even seen yet, but they didn't. All they did is help the establishment force as it was.
I mean, I don't understand what he's saying. He sounds super statist at this point, but we'll see. We'll see what he means. Uber when we come back.
Freedom Fiends with Michael Dean and his weird friends.
Mr. Michael Dean, and this is my show, Freedom Fiends.
I love that.
I hope you like it. If you don't, I don't really care. I don't make it for the masses. I make it for the cool weirdos who are up late at night. Insomniacs, swing shift workers, the homeless. Yeah.
People in other countries.
People in other countries who are at their day job that's 9 to 5. Good point. Good point. The unemployed, the underemployed, the worried.
Okay, y'all. Now, if y'all are feeling a little worried tonight and you've got a hamster running around in your brain, we have a solution for you. Just put your hands on your computer or your telephone, and the spirit of fiends is going to come right through, and it's going to
Yeah, I had to take him in, babe.
That is Amanda.
Friday, what? To 2 a.m. What is Amanda? Central time, and weekends, noon what are you talking about?
Amanda is on Freedom Fiends.
Amanda who?
Amanda Parsons.
Amanda Parsons is on Freedom Fiends?
She was just on that commercial.
In Survivor Max I just put it on. I'm 99% sure Amanda Parsons is not on Freedom Fiends.
Well, what is she on?
Nothing.
No, she does a show. Her she and used Ottinger do a
yes,
show.
Unity Evolved is the name of that show, and it's been defunct for like 6 months.
No, they...
Unity Evolved...
Okay, let's go look
oh
at her profile.
God,
she does a show, and they were talking about it.
Yes, but Amanda Parsons used to co-host Uni Evolved, and she also used to co-host for a short time the Corey Moore Show, but she has never been on Freedom Fiends. You're talking about an LRN and Liberty Podcast Junkie.
Okay. Well, I'm saying she's on something.
I think she might be doing another podcast
she is
as
doing
of right now,
something.
But it's not
yeah.
Freedom Fiends.
Well, it's called Fiends or something because I've heard her say it multiple times.
Unbelievable.
funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the director's cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
I just did a really stupid snap.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM are: 1. Let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM on your social networking profile. 2. Buy the things you buy online through shop.lrn.fm. 3. Give $5 a month to the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm. It's my firm belief that the AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented groups. Support all your favorite organizations, but make sure you give $5 a month to the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Tuesday, gold is down $4 at $1,080 per ounce. Silver is down 5 cents at $14.29 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $332. Robertson Roberts Brokerage is a trusted name in precious metals since 1977. We're serious about precious metals. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
Is it my turn to bring it back?
Enjoy LRN.FM.
Yes.
Okay, I do want to mention our exercise.
Oh, yeah.
Before we get into Uber, I'll bring it back. And back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, we were discussing my journey through Star Wars and how I have high hopes for happy endings.
Don't be too happy, babe. There are some.
Nevertheless, I'm excited to see it with you on Christmas Eve. That'll be fun. It's an open event. Everyone should come see it with us if you're in Manch, Vegas.
Baby.
Before we get into Uber activism, we are getting hot.
Well, first off, we already are hot, and you're gorgeous, but we can do better.
Thank you. Yeah, we can both do better.
I mean, yeah.
So there's a guy in the community, and he's like just the statue of fitness. He's always exercising, and he posts to this group. We have it's a naked hike that's happening.
So
what's the details?
Here's the details. There is a planned naked hike at Porkfest. Where sometime, I forget what day at Porkfest, but we're going to go hiking up in the mountains and be completely naked. And there is an accountability group. It's a workout accountability group. Basically, it was the same thing for there's a Speedo day at Hampton Beach. This is like a sequel to that. So the whole idea is to post status updates and kind of call people out that aren't exercising and hold them accountable so everyone gets in shape. Now, for me, obviously, I want to look really damn good for our wedding, you know.
And for this naked hike.
Exactly.
I'm so glad they're having a naked hike at Porkfest because
I hope a lot of people join that. I want it to be like 100 strong. That'd be awesome.
No, that would be awesome, especially because they've had like such stigma about nudity in the
past. Because last year there was, I forget the guy's name, but he was walking around butt ass naked with Derek J, no less, and they went and sat down, had lunch, and I remember walking up over to him and I literally just shook his hand and said, "That man, you're a hero." Apparently,
the naked man.
Yeah, hey, free the tits, free the balls. You know, why stop at lady nipples? You know. Everyone should be able to be walking around naked. It's a human body. You shouldn't be offended. Not that I want everyone to. It's everyone's prerogative whether to do it or not.
But I'm glad they're just becoming more open to it. It just sounds fun. I'm excited.
Well, yeah, I'm very excited about it.
I hope it's just really nice out that day. And I can just let it all loose. No pictures, though. Wait, do you care about pictures?
I don't.
I don't want anyone taking pictures. I'm so tired of people.
There's already people have taken a lot. There's a lot of pictures of you that floated around from the big gay dance party last year anyways.
Well, at least this time I'll be fitter, so I won't care as much about the pictures.
Well, I need to be fitter, too. Looking at those pictures, I kind of want to take one of them and just like put it on the wall and just workout.
What are you doing other than to diet and work out?
Dieting a lot. Definitely be eating healthy. You know, cutting back on any kind of snack or anything that, like, don't get any food out unless it's at a really nice restaurant and it's lean. I'm not gonna have that. I'm not gonna drink any beer anymore. Like, I'm done for beer for
a
while.
But we still have beer in the fridge.
I know. Someone else is
going
to have to drink that. I guess we won't. We'll have to save that for Saturday because Cody's probably going to be coming down here and doing off-the-air live. So the next off-the-air live is going to be recorded at the Rebel Love Studios here in Manch Vegas. Just eating healthy. But exercising a lot, especially we started doing Just Dance exercise.
Yeah, we just danced the hell out of some Just Dance, and I'm the champion.
Barely. She barely bit me.
Please. Anyway, anywho.
I want a few of those songs. Apparently, according to the Xbox 360, I'm a better dancer at some songs than you are, babe. You just gotta deal with
you
that shit.
You just have longer arms. But anyway.
What does that mean? What is that?
I
love that excuse. I don't even know what that means as an excuse.
I don't know, but can I actually just like point out how I love the fact that we have something like Facebook where we can all, it just made me feel better because today I ate low carb all day and it was my first time doing it all day and I was like, I'm proud of myself and I was like, I can post this on Facebook and like that'll like encourage people and they're like, yeah, I need to do something too. So I started doing it and I danced today and I did like some crunches and a solid dance off with myself. So I got my exercise in, so I think I'm going to be fit for Porkfest. I'm going to lose 10 pounds. I'm saying this on it. 10 pounds.
I want to lose like 20, at least, maybe more. I need to lose weight.
I feel like we've been getting a lot of workouts, even doing activism. I feel like we've been walking a lot.
You feel like you've been walking a lot because most of the day you just sit around on your ass.
That's not true.
That is pretty damn true.
No, I dance around. I'm naked.
What?
Yeah.
Why don't you do that when I'm here?
I don't know. Mm-hmm.
Well, you need to do that more when I'm here.
Anywho.
But I'm on my feet every day. My job dictates I'm on my feet all the time.
But either way, this has been a busy week for us. Like, we've been driving back and forth to Portsmouth, standing in the cold, waving signs at people, doing interviews, all in support of the Uber.
Free Uber.
Where were we last night? What happened?
Last night? Yeah, that was last night. So, okay, the free Uber stuff that's going on in Portsmouth. A little bit of the backstory.
I was going to read Chris David's open letter, so let me just find it.
All right, well, you just passed it. That was the open. No, that's the other side. Oh, yeah. You just go to my profile. Okay. I have it on there.
Got you.
While she's looking that up, the whole thing is Christopher David got arrested in Portsmouth for not being an Uber driver, but basically being an Uber driver for videotaping himself being an Uber driver and having to deal with bouncers.
That is a horrible way to tell the story. He got arrested.
That's why he got arrested. That bouncers filed wiretapping charges against him.
Yes, but what happened specifically was he was outside picking up a customer, and the guy was angry because he was an Uber driver, and the bouncer called the police on him, and the police came because he was an Uber driver, and then he was filming the cops.
And the reason why the police came because he's an Uber driver is because the city of Portsmouth has basically banned Uber for the most part, unless they follow a bunch of their rules and regulations.
Which are ridiculous.
Right.
Which, okay, so let's just go into the city council meeting last night. First of all, does being in government buildings make you itch?
I literally felt like I was in a cult, like inside some sort of crazy cult. It was intense. I've never actually go to city council meetings, so I hate government. So why do I want to go inside of it? And
what do you think about all these portraits? Just the portraits of people.
Oh,
it's
so religious because it's kind of like, you know, these are our saints. You know, these are people that, like, if remember in, like, grade school when you saw all the different presidents' pictures, like, in, like, history class? I don't know if you had that in your history class. I had that in mine. And every single, like, all the major presidents are, like, the big ones, you know, like Lincoln and Washington and FDR.
Oh, and painted in these murals.
You know, yeah. Like, they're held up as, like, higher than thou saints. That, like, they're responsible for our civilization. And, you know, they should be redeemed as our founding fathers. You know? And we, like, in beginning a class, you stand up and put your hand over your chest and you pledge allegiance to their flag, just the, you know, like all that, like that was in school. And that's what it is in, like, literally the city council was like that. And you kind of forget that living a voluntarist life and a liberty life and being around so many you know, libertarians within Manch Vegas and New Hampshire in general, in the Shire, you forget that those people exist and they're in mass numbers. You really do. And when you're in a city council meeting and it was a pack, it wasn't a packed house, but there was a lot of people in there, and we're sitting up near the front, and almost everyone around us got up and stared at the flag and prayed to it. And even the city council members, the flag's like on the wall behind them, so they all turn around and they're all looking at it. And it was literally like a small little tiny moment in time where I literally felt like me and Anne were only people there, and everyone else was around us like praying to the wall. It felt creepy. My skin, I felt like I wanted to get out of my own skin. Like it was a creepy, creepy moment that the average person would like not even bat an eye, and they'd just be fine with it.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think I've ever felt. I mean, we've talked about the pledge before, but I just don't ever think I've felt comfortable with it. Praying to anyone, for that matter. Now, that's just, like, this thing that represents death. Like, no matter how you put it, people fought for this flag. Yeah, they fought. They died. They killed. They murdered people. Like, this flag does represent death. And that's not something I want to pledge my allegiance to. So I just can't see why this is still a tradition. Like, I remember the pledge, and I remember all the controversy with the pledge, and I think that's great that people are, like, starting to say, you know, why do I have to say this shit? Like, it's like you're signing a bit of your soul over each time, which is just ridiculous.
Yeah, the fact that, like, there's even a pledge that exists, you know, I mean, I actually know some of the history of the pledge.
Well, tell us when we come back. I want to know.
Maybe.
I don't know
if I remember even bring that up.
I don't know any history.
No, a little bit.
No, none. Fuck the flag. I'm just kidding.
Successful at what you do, whether you're a
what?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, can you close that door? I know. What to both the fucking animals. Both today have been horrible. $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month, and this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. Oh, this is a long break. You're starting a long break. Non-tobacco user may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for small
businesses. Wait, why am I
cutting off my head?
Why don't you take it?
With what?
With
how do I take a...
Move it to...
Oh, wait. I got this. I'm trying some Snapchat activism. If you're looking at the green screen, because that's how weird we are. There we go. Okay. That's really bizarre. Then I found. All right, I want to flip the camera and watch this.
I was told it would remove stains, so I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable.
What?
With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out
there. No, I was doing. I'll take a picture too. Now you're fucking it up, babe.
150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
LRN.FM is proud to announce our.
I'm sending it anyways.
For Android and iOS devices.
I also want to take a picture.
Tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for lrn.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to lrn.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
My arms look fat. I need to lose some
arms. That's a horrible tongue picture of me. I don't like tongue pictures of me at all.
Well, don't stick your tongue out.
What you're doing? I got to do a weird face.
Okay, well,
I can't be the only one smiling or grinning. I hate my smile.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the
world. You need to get over it.
I know. I need to get over the fact I can't smile. That's a hard thing to get over.
You just need to get over
yourself.
It's
a hard thing to get over.
You need to get over yourself.
Imagine coming to the realization that you're a horrible smiler. You can't go up from that.
You're just a horrible selfie taker.
You take horrible selfies,
too. I take great selfies.
No, that one picture of you on the trippy pillow, that's a horrible selfie.
What?
It's a horrible selfie. I hate
on
that selfie.
Trippy pillow?
Yeah, you used it in your... You had it as your profile picture
the
for a while.
The vomiting rainbow?
No, not the vomiting rainbow one. The one before that.
What? state. Let me go back and look at my history of profile pictures. The one when I was vomiting the rainbow, right? Seem to have come with a new
willingness to compromise. No.
This one?
No, the one before that.
This one?
Yes!
This one's
oh my
great.
God. Can we show
this
that to the camera?
I gotta
show it. Wait. I gotta change it. I gotta go back to Wirecast. Hold on.
This is a great photo of me. This right. photo has so many like saying no. flawless.
Show the audience. Look at okay. I hate this photo. I hate it for so many reasons. Like it. I don't like the angle of it. Like you need to be up higher. You need to have a higher up angle.
No, it's like the purpose. I'm lying on the bed taking a selfie. Like that's how it's supposed to look. Like I'm lying on the bed taking
just,
a selfie.
It's
don't
not
you
a flattering
come
photo of
live
you.
Beside me?
It's
what?
Not a flattering
what?
Photo.
My
I don't
eyes
like it.
Look,
I'm a great judge of character when it comes to
my
some of those things.
My jawbone looks great in this photo.
I will say your jawbone does look spectacular. In that photo.
Then that's all that matters.
Why is that all that matters?
Because that's all that matters, babe.
Is that what?
I don't make the rules.
Why does that?
I don't make the rules. Okay, except for how I do.
Like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin. God damn it, the cat opened the door again. The minimum purchase is she in here? Orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts and Roberts today for knowledgeable advice. Yeah, she's chilling on the chair. And a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760. Hey, is there anything going on in the chat? I actually even looked.
Yeah, but I can't keep track.
Well, that's usually a good thing if that's the case.
That just means the chat tends to talk about whatever they want to talk about. They're just using this as a forum. Presented in an interactive web exhibit created
by the Guardian newspaper called The Council. I have no idea what's going on in the chat.
Yeah, Islam, like, what? Even though some guy did say that ISIS runs Uber. There is no official tally of people killed or wounded by law enforcement officers in the United States, but by all accounts, the 1,000 victim mark is a significant milestone. California leads the nation in police-related deaths, according to The Guardian. They're the only state with a tally over 100, with 183 apparently, newbie doesn't think I can be a Sith. He doesn't know what I can be. He doesn't know. Hey, can we back up the bowl again? Rhode Island, North Dakota, and Maine each have one. One particularly staggering statistic
is this.
Only 55
I like taking turns.
Yeah.
I like it.
Because I'm just such a great host. I'm just so great because I know how.
You're a fantastic co-host.
I can't wait till my book comes out.
What?
My book comes out. I'm going to go on a book sharing screen. Everyone download
that's
gonna,
babe, that audiobook is going to it's gonna set like the character of who you are for generations to come. Imagine like you build like a whole huge following based off of that audiobook.
Reports a Utah judge who sparked an outcry when he ordered a foster child to be taken from the home of her married lesbian foster parents removed himself from the case on Monday. 7th District Court Judge Scott Johansson disqualified.
Hey, Webkeys. How's it going? Court's presiding
judge, Mary Manley. Hey, dude.
The foster parents, Becky Pierce and April, had cared for the 9-month-old girl since August, but Johansson last week ordered state child welfare workers
hey,
to remove
there?
The baby from
yeah,
the
I mean, don't be Rich Paul on me with the fucking pick.
And ordered the child be placed with new foster parents within 7 days.
You know, a co-worker, Rich Paul me?
Did you tell him?
The Rich Paul me? No. I had a lighter in my pocket, which I never actually have a lighter in my pocket because I don't smoke cigarettes. I don't ever really carry pot with me.
But you did this.
No, the reason why I had a lighter is because remember I told you on that date I was gonna light her up if like things went good.
So fucking lame.
Yeah, she was so lame to the point I didn't even want to waste my pot on her. So I smoked the bowl while I was driving home.
No pot for you, man.
But that's why I had a lighter on me.
Also showed that the nation would once again endure traumatic childhood memories, Twitter, anxiety, poverty, consumerism, rampant abuses of the racial inequality, global warming,
the steady erosion of civil liberties.
No, Kickstart. Rich Paul means Rich Paul is notorious for stealing lighters. If you ever smoke with Rich Paul, he's going to steal your fucking Bic. He's going to take it every single time.
For more on this unending story, check this week's Onion Review.
This is the Onion News Network.
All right, and welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And if you're listening on LRN.fm or if you're subscribed to us on iTunes or Stitcher and listen to this podcast, we actually broadcast live every Tuesday night at 10 p.m. on LRN.fm, IPM Nation, and TheRebelLoveShow.com. Not only on TheRebelLoveShow.com can you hear the audio, but you can actually watch the studio cam, which is at the Rebel Love Studio. We have multiple different camera angles. We got green screens going on. We have guests on from time to time, which you can watch. And if you go to rebelloveshow.com, click on live, we also have the LRN chat embedded, so you can chat and watch at the same time. And we do interact with the chat from time to time.
Like now. Like if you're listening live, go vote for Porkfest.
Go what?
Go vote for Porkfest.
What do you mean vote for Porkfest? What are you talking
for
about?
For the best fest. 300. You can go and find my status on the Rebel Mistress and go upvote Porkfest because I think it only has like 600 likes now. So, just that was my activism. That's my social network.
That's your activism for the day.
That was my social network. If you're listening, like, okay.
We were talking about Uber before the long break. I know long break, whenever there's a long break, you forget what you're talking about. I mean, how I forget about what I'm talking about each segment. But Uber activism going down in Portsmouth. We're talking about the city council, all that jazz. So this past Monday, the city council was voting on whether or not to amend the transportation,
to look at the amendment. Like,
Some bullshit, so much
micromanaging, first of all. So I think it was like to accept to look at the amendments that Uber has requested, which is, okay, so it was three. And the first one is they want the drivers to all have limited liability insurance.
And which I think Uber already requires.
Uber requires
almost all the things that they say Uber, that Uber already does.
Uber
but
requires
not
your car to have insurance. Yes, absolutely. But the state just wants a piece of that. It can't be, you know. It has. They want those records. I don't know. They just want information. They want every Uber driver to get a background check, which they already do. They want to keep
it's not
those.
To their standard. They want
the cops to keep the. Have those on file, and they want them to be vetted by their police officers. So police officers
they
have
need
to say
know who's
yes,
driving.
Has to say yes, you
know.
Can be an Uber driver.
Yeah.
And Portsmouth, I mean, Uber says that's ridiculous. Like there's no way they can meet those standards because
imagine if Uber had to literally go follow every single local municipality regulation
of everywhere
they're
they
like
are.
A multi-million dollar company, but besides that, they're an app, and their goal is literally to be in every city on the planet, I would assume. And
yeah,
how are they
there
gonna
are a lot of places.
I mean, how are they gonna accommodate for every single city that it operates in? That's impossible. Like, that's literally impossible for them to do.
I think they have, like, a great process already. And guess what? It's working so efficiently everywhere else. It's just making Portsmouth look like assholes. Like, do they even have apps on their phone? That was the one question I wanted to ask. Just pull out your phone. I bet all of them had Nokias, flip phones. Like, they are not up to date with what is technology. Like,
what's crazy
Uber's
is
old news. People should be having ripoffs of
the
Uber
law
like
they've
Boston.
Put in, the law they've put into place literally makes using an app illegal. Like, you're literally using an app, and the sheer act of using that app can literally end you in a jail cell at some point. Like, case in point, Stephanie Friends, she's the Uber grandma, if you haven't been paying attention to what's going on out there. It's not just Christopher David as an Uber driver. There's other Uber drivers, one of which is this grandma. Her husband passed away not too long ago, and she's a part-time bus driver, and she wanted to get out of the house and meet new people and whatnot. What better way than be an Uber driver? And she's now gotten two tickets from the
amounting $1,500,
which she refuses to pay and is continuing on this struggle. She actually has a court date that I know a lot of people want to show up to.
Oh, yeah. They actually, the cops pulled her over and they had to put out two teen college girls who had no other ride. Like, I bet these girls, like, are in the dark. She said it was 2 a.m. and they pulled her over. These two girls, they kicked them out of the car and they said, "We don't have any other way." They said, "Oh, well, for your safety."
Yeah.
So, you're going to leave me in the middle of
because this Uber grandma, who, by the way, goes through a bunch of background checks and everything like that to be a bus driver, all right, a school bus driver, apparently might be some sort of rapist to these teenage girls or whatever, however old they were. And they were drunk, and it was like 12:30 middle of the night, and they were forced out of the Uber car without a ride, and the police didn't take them home.
And how did that make them safer? And that's their point. Like, is this what cops do all day? They go harass grandmas for taking drunk people? Like, they aren't hurting anybody.
They're not. Well, here's the thing. They're According helping. To the taxi cartels, which were very present at that meeting, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
I found it interesting.
You have to follow the rules.
That was their...
To do business here in Portsmouth.
That was like their only... But what about this? Follow the rules. And there was one guy, I can't remember his name, but he didn't get reelected. I know that. But he was making so much sense. He was like, "I don't understand why we're even having this committee. Like, why this is an issue. There is way too much regulation."
Yeah,
they don't regulate limos. They don't regulate horse and buggies. Like, none
buses
of the buses, any of that. And he was like, "How does that not require the same amount of safety?" And I'm not saying tax those people. I'm saying stop the taxing.
Apparently, well, not just that, but apparently with the background checks are only done on taxi drivers and on ride shares. That's it. And there's all these different things
and government officials
that are in place within Portsmouth that should probably be has more health and safety concerns than a taxi driver or a Uber driver.
Okay, so first of all, one of the things that I found extra interesting during the meeting, they said they already changed the rules for Uber because originally they only allowed 28 taxi medallions. 28.
That's it. What?
Like, we already changed the rules for them.
And why would, like, in all honesty, like, taxi medallion thing, it's not like unique to Portsmouth either, where the taxis, there's only so many, there's a finite amount of medallions that go out and they have to pay them for it. But at the same time, the taxis that can afford that and do that, they kind of have a monopoly over how many people can get rides. And the fact there's only 28 at the time, that's ridiculous. That's why Uber can be so successful, because they're cheaper, more convenient,
they have
better service, less creepy, and there's more of them. You know?
The other thing I really like about Uber, which I feel like these people had not even bothered. Like, I mean, that's the purpose of the city council. They hadn't even bothered to see what Uber was requesting and if that would be viable, because they were too busy saying, "No, these are the rules." And so they did vote to look at that amendment, and I think that's going to be in January. When is
it? They're going to, I forget when they have another vote.
But
on
what
it,
do you think is going to be the outcome of that?
I honestly think, looking at this, I don't see the city council bending anytime soon. I honestly think that it might be, I honestly see the Uber grandma getting arrested at one point before things get better. Maybe Christopher David again if he keeps being an Uber driver. I don't have a high optimistic view that they're going to change Uber in there after that city council meeting.
Okay.
Like, it was very determined. It was very evident that the taxi cartel of Portsmouth is playing ball with the city council, and Uber is not, because Uber's not giving them kickbacks to change the laws. They're going to go with the people paying them.
I mean,
and that's how I see it. I mean, that's politics.
This, like, is how I see
they're,
it.
They're very cold-hearted.
But you're saying they don't have any weak spots, though. Like, Uber needs them. Uber doesn't fucking need Portsmouth.
Yeah.
So if Uber decides to stop using Portsmouth, first of all, I feel really bad for the Uber grandma, which that would have to be the extent Uber pulls out of Portsmouth. Uber has all the power here. Because if Uber pulls out of Portsmouth and then go global, and Portsmouth is the only place without Uber, then they'll say, "Oh, no, like, I guess we'll change." What are they going to do? Like, and you can't stop an app. As long as someone has the ability to download that app, they can take an Uber. So it's like trying to stop the ocean with a broom, as someone said.
Yeah, there's no way they're going to be able to stop Uber, but it's eventually they're just going to give up. But
or Uber is going to fucking leave, but it's and it's going to look
no,
bad
Uber's
at one Portsmouth.
I don't see Uber doing that, to be honest. I hope they don't. I hope they leave it running during this time, because I want to see this play out.
Let's see.
Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running.
My headphones are low. I should have heard that coming.
Yeah, I tapped on my.
To humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed,
okay.
Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole.
Parole.
Now,
parole.
An appeal is Ross's only chance. He needs
Ross.
Your support.
I know. I hope Chris doesn't end up like
you
Ross.
Can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit
I don't think
Chris.
It'll get that far.
Oh, Ross. Chris for David?
Because felony wiretap.
No.
But maybe it will. They're animals. They don't
the,
care.
The felony wiretapping, I think he'll be fine with. I don't see that. I don't see that being an issue, to be honest.
And is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom,
his
love,
name
and
messaging.
Liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc.
Oh, we should mention that we were going to have Chris on, but
Creative Commons.
He's giving birth.
If you can't listen to Liberty Radio Network's internet streams, free satellite
channel, or
radio affiliates, no
and
worries.
We can talk about some more
you can
stuff.
Listen to LRN.com
more what?
From any
Uber
phone.
Oh, yeah, we can do another segment
at
on Uber.
This number to your phone, 213-493-0309. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Liberty Radio Network listen lines are locked into our stream 24 hours a day. Call 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas.
I don't even know him.
Your amp will directly
oh, I know who he is.
More lives by getting
I don't know. I literally I
think
talked to him four
talk
times over.
Online and on the air. When you amp Free Talk Live, you get perks like access to the Amp Only Facebook group and Amp Podcast. Visit amp.freetalklive.com. DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.lrn.fm. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit the Liberty Radio Network when you shop at Amazon via shop.lrn.fm. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
Yeah.
Okay, I got it.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
And And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. We're just talking about Uber activism. We've been driving up to Portsmouth, which is really nice because the Uber people actually, they just gave us a reimbursement, you know, and that's awesome. We didn't even ask. Like, we were going to put it back into the funds. But we've been driving up to Portsmouth and making our signs and going up there and showing our, like, frustration with the city of Portsmouth. And can I just say, in that room, they were trying to wait us out. Like, you could just feel it. You could feel it as if they may have planned it. Like, some woman first came up to talk about power plants. About building of getting the EPA to regulate the regulators and regulating all of everyone. I don't know. But during the process of her long rant, which never came to a point, I am not stupid. Some people may disagree, but I am not daft or dumb. Like, I could not just, she was just talking in circles and circles and circles, but with a passion. But about nothing.
She was very gung-ho about EPA regulations and, like, this power plant.
But I couldn't tell, like, where her position was, what she was trying to fight for. Like, was she part of the EPA? Was she not? Like, what was her goal plan? What was her game plan? Like, you couldn't tell. And everyone was just on Facebook, like, what is going on? We started just, like, the long
So if you're following me on Facebook, I was actually posting photos as they were happening of stuff that was going on in front of me. And I even posted, like, the open letter that Christopher David did. I actually took a picture of it in front of the city council. And I think it was one of those photos or something like that. There's just a all the activists that were there ended up just chatting on the one photo.
Just about what's going on.
About what's going on in front of us.
Because they were trying to bore us out. I was like, that's what it is. They're trying to bore us out of here.
It literally became a group chat, but instead of it being in a group messenger, it was actually on the photo.
No, it was great. And she was just, oh my gosh, she was horrible. She was just horrible. And after she left, another guy came up who I thought was very interesting, actually. Wait, was that? That's how it happened. The water plant lady talked forever.
That was like for an hour. And it was horrible to sit through. I almost wanted to get up. Like,
everyone was like, should we leave?
Should we leave?
And I was like, no, guys, we got to stay strong. I literally said that. Go read the comment. And they were trying to wait us out, but we all stayed. And they finally moved it up in the agenda because they had more stuff to go over. And I was like, oh, my God. Yeah. No. But anyway, after that lady, it was some guy. Who was
you talking about the first speaker?
No, the guy who, not Chris David's speaker.
You talking about the Uber driver that was reading his open letter?
The Uber driver who read Chris David's open letter did an amazing job. You can go find that on Rob's Facebook page.
Record fast enough where he said his name. Like, oh, I gotta record this. And I should have been recording from the get-go. But I know Daryl Perry was actually live streaming the entire thing. So if you go to Daryl Perry's, I'm sure it's on fpp.say, go there or his radio show. I forget the name of it. But anyways, Daryl Perry, he was live streaming, so I know
I interviewed with him, and that was really great. But he was the guy who came up after.
Peace, Love, Liberty Radio, that's it.
Yeah, the guy who came up after was talking on corruption. Actually, so it had nothing to do with Uber activism. He was
My God. So apparently the former Manch head of the PD here in Manchester, head of the police department, during the chalking incident. So there was basically four off-duty cops years ago. They beat the hell out of someone at Strange Brew. And there was this whole incident where, like, they were basically, the police didn't want to investigate. It was a big thing on the face of the police, and he was the police chief at the time. And there's actually an incident where multiple different porcupines all went up to the old Manchester Police Department and started chalking on, because there's like the whole huge cement wall around it. So just chalking on the wall of, you know,
what were,
like,
they writing?
A lot of cop lock stuff, like, you know, no victim, no crime, and also just protesting the cover up of that and a lot of other different stuff. But anyways, a lot of people were arrested, like multiple people.
Apparently, this were was arrested. The part
it was
two.
Nine people were arrested. This is before my time. I remember watching a video one time. Like, I actually discovered this happened a year after I moved, and I know it was a big deal back then.
Was that the last time? And then the same guy they were talking about the corruption is now the commissioner commissioner of...
The same police chief then, or commissioner, I forget the titles they use, but he is now in the runnings to be the head of the police in Portsmouth.
In Portsmouth, and the
this
guy
guy's
was
bringing
like,
all this stuff, and I'm like, oh my
yeah,
god, that
he's
happened.
Like, if you Google this guy's name, like, you can see his ties, and we can obviously see that there's a favoritism in how are we paying our tax dollars to, you know,
really
have people promoting their friends.
I remember looking at the mayor's face during that. He was like, oh my god,
they
get this guy out of here.
They didn't say anything about it either.
Yeah. They didn't even recognize the fact that that guy even said anything. They just moved on to Uber. Like, Uber was actually saving them from that incident.
Yes,
you know,
that's what happened.
I think they actually jumped to that just to get rid
of
that
guy. They
were
like, okay, like, no, two bad things going on here.
Let's move to the next one. Like, let's keep going.
I mean, that was great. I feel like it really helped Uber's cause in a way. You see people in Portsmouth like, oh, hey, that's my buddy. Oh, he's going to be police chief now. He's moving up here. And do you think there's going to be a chalking Portsmouth? No, probably not.
Now, one thing I do want to say about this whole Uber stuff, and this is a side change in my mind, but I love the fact that the free coasters are becoming full keen. Like,
oh my god,
full keen is happening.
You can't say
on
that
the coast
about
and
people.
I love that because, like, you know, most people hold this this viewpoint that there's a stereotype of free coasters that they love to fart in wine glasses at the Praxium. Like, that's like the idea that people have a free coaster. No. Christopher Davis just like flipping that on its head. Like, completely flipping it. The civil disobedience, like the fact that he's running out there with a huge beard, like
I've actually met several cool free coasters now.
Oh no, there are definitely cool free coasters. I'm just saying that's a stereotype, and this is like redefining like the cultural identity of free coasters. It's literally changing the paradigm. There's gonna be people that move based off of Christopher David and move to sea coast
years,
and just change it all up.
Be a portrait of Chris David up there.
Well, it'd probably be a movie poster. Who knows? Maybe be a documentary. This is just the beginning of his victimless crime spree.
I
want to
be in it.
It'd be a sequel to Derek Chase, but it's going to be Christopher David.
Exactly. I mean, I hope everything goes well for him, though, and relatively smooth.
Oh, me
smooth.
Too. And he has a son coming on the way, too.
Probably here.
It might
he
be now.
Facebook.
Yeah, he might have been born right now during the show. Who knows?
But, I mean, I wish nothing but... I kind of want it to be quick and over with for him because I don't want him to have to spend time in a cage, you know?
No.
And then on the other hand, it's like, I know he's going to fight for it. You know, he's not just going to go down easy. So we'll see how this plays out.
He definitely has convictions in this.
Yeah.
So I'm definitely going home for him.
And his felony wiretapping. You know... Since we didn't even mention it, Artsy Fartsy, the president of the FSP read her story, which I hadn't heard before, and it was really amazing.
So, like, the backtrack, Artsy Fartsy, for those that don't really know, there's always it's usually like once a Shire year, there's an Artsy Fartsy party where people read poems and music and play music and stand-up comedy and all that jazz.
And the president told her story of her felony wiretapping. When they threatened her with that, and that was great. So.
And we'll talk about it when we come back.
Every once in a while, you get information
a really cool
that's
graphic.
Worth changing your
yeah.
life for.
Sometimes it's
Where'd you find that one? You
can I just downloaded it off of YouTube. Just like every other one. I think I typed in DMT simulation, and this is what
it's
I found.
Like super groovy. That's
I know. I love this background, and that's I love the fact that I don't follow IP. I wouldn't have been able to create this.
You think someone has intellectual property over there?
I don't think so, but you never know. I and open an
account. Do this right now. Don't wait.
Come back.
And you fund the account with Bitcoin. I know this sounds unbelievable, but at my house, we saved as much as 45% off of a new item on Amazon. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveatpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at creditsuccesssecretsrevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
SWCPoker.eu is Bitcoin Poker 2.0, where players can buy chips, play, and cash out anonymously with Bitcoin. No banking, just Bitcoin. Texas Hold'em, Omaha Hold'em, draw, and many new games, including Chinese poker. SWC Poker gladly accepts players worldwide, and over 2 million hands of Bitcoin Poker have been dealt at SWCPoker.eu. Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust. SWCPoker.eu.
Did you know you can listen to LRN.FM via our free-to-air satellite channels? We have channels over nearly all of North America and much of Africa. All you need is an affordable receiver, dish as small as 30 inches. There are no fees. Learn more at sat.lrn.fm. Plus, if you are a broadcaster or want to be one, good delivery method for our content.
Oh, I know.
Details at sat.lrn.fm. What do you know?
What's going on,
Hannah?
What's going on with
Chad?
I don't know. But Rand Paul.
Rand Paul. And improving it. Fuck Rand Paul.
This is Charlie Sunstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute.
Really hate Rand Paul. Component of your credit with passion.
Is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts. Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit.
He's never made anything as beautiful as Ron Paul. Ron Paul is so beautiful and poetic, and
maintain a healthy credit score.
Made you feel warm inside, you know. Ron Paul's just the status.
It's better to have a high credit limit.
He makes you feel warm inside as a status.
No, I said Rand Paul is just a status. Ron Paul makes you feel warm inside.
You need several accounts in order to have a credit score.
Yeah, right. You listen to his videos, like, they're amazing. Like those words just float into your head and like illuminate your life.
Have you ever seen MLS? You should actually go back if you ever get a chance. Watch Rand Paul's farewell speech from the floor of the House. It's really good.
Liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty
I've heard him speak in person, huh? Anyway. And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. I feel like media in the Shire just has not stopped since Keen Vengeance. I feel like we've just been on the move trying to be active as possible, trying to create a freer society, whatever we can do. If it's stand outside, hold a sign, donate to agorist charities. We're using Bitcoin on a daily basis.
I haven't even talked about Shire Sharing coming up this weekend.
Like, you know, we do what we can. I feel like there's been a lot of great coverage of the subject, and Chris David actually got... Rand Paul. Well, no, Rand Paul came to Chris David. Sorry, and took an illegal Uber.
Yeah. So yeah, Rand Paul
to his to sign his. What I don't know.
I don't. Well, Rand Paul found out about Christopher David's civil disobedience and how like he's facing these charges over being an Uber driver. So now, mind you. Hate Rand Paul with a passion. I hope that God or whatever
like
that
him.
Rand Paul doesn't become president. I am not a Rand Paul fan in any way, shape, or form. So don't construe this as me being supportive of Rand Paul. But I'm going to put my minarchist cap on for a second. So Rand Paul wanted to go get a ride from Christopher David because he heard about what's going on. He's all for the small businessman and all that jazz.
The state staying out of your business.
You know, and Rand Paul wanted to commit an act of civil disobedience with Christopher David. He interviewed Christopher David in his own car and put it on his Facebook and how he paid an Uber to Christopher David to drive him to like some town hall meeting he had in Portsmouth.
I thought it was to sign his like whatever, and that had 100,000 views.
I don't think that was up to go sign. No, I don't think
it was. Let's ask the chat. You guys find out. Okay. But anyway, And it has over 100,000 views, which is more than his signing even has, which is pretty.
Yeah, it's awesome. Impressive. It was great. The fact that he got a presidential candidate to do some civil disobedience with him is pretty damn cool. Like, I've never heard of a president
doing
something
like that.
Why do you
hate Rand Paul so much? Only thing I know is that his status, like, I've heard him say things like he'd keep the troops overseas. But, like, I don't really like any politician, so.
He's not. First off, he's not his dad. He's not his dad any way, shape, or form. I don't even know where to begin. He's tried to have journalists arrested for asking questions in the Senate. That happened to what's her name from RT? I forget her name. A journalist from RT that was working with Luke Radowski. They're doing like a joint thing together. He has said that he's basically very pro-war Iran. Like, we'll pro sanctions on Iran, and sanctions are an act of war, in my opinion. And his father would say the exact same thing. He has multiple times said he's in favor of the drug war. He doesn't think a lot of drugs should be legal, including pot. He thinks pot should be illegal.
And you know Ron had to be lighting a few.
Yeah.
While he was a kid. Why is he such a statist?
He's saying what he's not playing. Ron Paul spoke his mind. Now, mind you, there are these people, these libertarians and voluntarists and anarchists and all that jazz out there that say, well, he's still one of us guys, and he's just playing the game. He's trying a different strategy.
Do people think that he's pretending?
Yes.
Like, then we shouldn't be talking about it on.
No, seriously. There are people out there to this day that still love Ron Paul. Don't get me wrong, I still love Ron Paul.
So, do you think he's pretending? Just to get in the White House and then he's going to release full anarchists? He'll fire everyone and then himself.
I don't think him as being one of us and just changing strategies and saying what he needs to say to get elected and to get into the White House. Somehow.
Why not?
It's just hard to believe, and on top, it's as if he sold his soul to do it. I don't buy the strategy.
Who can sell their soul? Like, that's like
your soul
a pretty
to
big
get the
conspiracy.
Ring. It's selling your soul to get the ring. Like, you know, it's going against your beliefs.
Or maybe he's just so extreme that he is like willing to do anything, even like bomb brown people for a while.
Just so that he can take over the federal government and disband it.
Like, I couldn't do that. So maybe. I don't know, but maybe some people can. I don't know.
Maybe it's a possibility. I won't lie. It's a possibility, but I just can't. I don't believe it. I think he'll be, when you side with the dark side, I mean, you know, I consider myself kind of dark in many ways, but to get, there you go, babe. There you go. Just cough right in there. But if you're going to sell yourself to like get ahead, odds are you're going to get corrupted to begin with. So, even if once he gets into there, he's not going to be the person we want. In all honesty, like, I don't want someone who considers themselves a libertarian to be in office when the shit really hits the fan, because they're going to blame it more, and it's just going to swing the other way with even more progressives in control that there are than already are. I don't want Bernie Sanders in there.
I feel like it's MVG's Matthias von Gutenberg's his whole name. Did I say that right? Anyway, his theory that, you know, running for office and joining government is like trying to infiltrate the Klan. And in this instance, it's like trying to get all the way like up there. Well, you're gonna have to step over a lot of bodies, and that in itself would be enough to turn somebody the other way.
I will say this, I do like the I'm not against the idea of people doing, like, people that say they're one of us, you know, they're a libertarian or a minarchist or an anarchist, whatever, they're already there, and they're getting inside the system and doing whatever they can to at least slow it down or stop it, you know. So from that perspective, like, there's multiple different porks that are state reps, you know, there's like 15 or 20 of them at this point, you know, and there's multiple people in other city offices and stuff like that around the state. I'm supportive of them trying to do that. But at the same time, the analogy is very similar. Like, no, it's also similar in the fact that they probably can't do anything from inside. Hopefully they can. And they have actually in New Hampshire, but not that much. But I'm okay with them. It's like those people I know. I know it sounds weird, but it's local. It's like those people I know. So it's kind of like, all right, I believe you. I don't know. I could actually go walk up and talk to them. It doesn't sound weird,
but they're also not running for president. So,
that's true.
You know, it's one thing to be an alderman. It's another thing to try to run to be president.
That is true.
Yeah.
That
so,
is very, very
I
true.
I mean, I don't know, lesser of two evils in this case, maybe we can call it. But like I said, I've never voted. I never will vote. And if anyone should win, you're right. It shouldn't be a Liberty person. Because when shit hits the fan, guess who's going to help it get there? Donald Trump. Vote for him,
guys. No. You're not going to vote for Donald Trump.
He's who
you're going to vote for. Hillary Clinton
deserves.
No,
Hillary Clinton. You think so?
Yeah, I want to
see
Hillary.
I feel like she will hold this like as tight as a Kegel. Like, she will hold this presidency as tight as just, like, Kegeling.
It's her time. It's her time. And on top of that, when the shit hits the fan, I want there to be the most liberal person out, liberal status person possible.
But just
Trump would be a good one, though, too. I think he could really bring down the entire federal government within, like, a few weeks.
But this is why
Hillary
won't win. But not because the people who are really controlling government, they're already being compared to, like, this monarchy. So even you saying it's her time, like, she inherited the throne, which it is the case. It is the case. Yes. Like, but that's kind of why I think she won't win. I think that's why the powers that be won't let her win. It's not her time. And if she does win, that's going to
be
even better for us.
The ones that control it all anyways.
There's
going to
be so many memes. I hope you guys make those
national
memes.
Elections. Unless it literally got to the point where, like, someone had, like, a landslide popularity thing. But in the grand scheme of things, no one gives a shit about national elections. And it's all a charade. It's all a game. It's all, like, everyone out there is controlled by the same people. This is all for show. Like, that's all it really is.
Yeah.
You know, that's not going to...
They're just figureheads in this master plan.
Yeah, and I'm following the reality TV show known as the... Who's running for president? But at the grand scheme of things, I do want I always want the most status person to be president because I want that to be more. I want that to wake more people up. I don't want to delay.
It's like a harsh reality.
It's not delay. I don't want to delay the inevitable. I'm tired of waiting.
People don't.
You know,
see
this
it
is going to happen anyways.
You know. When we come back, we're going to get into volunteers. I mean. Charities? I don't know.
Yeah, volunteer charities. Sharing.
Yes,
Shire.
That's what we're
sharing.
Doing. More when we come back.
Day, Roberts and Roberts Brokerage celebrated the end of war by putting their money where their heart is, donating the profit of that day's sales to antiwar.com. Roberts and Roberts Brokerage is making this offer again on Bitcoin Black Friday, November 27th. Shop online at rrbi.co on Black Friday. And Roberts and Roberts.
That would have been funny if they actually said that on air. This is the coolest anti-war commercial I've ever heard. Roberts and Roberts has been your trusted source for precious metals. Oh, it's a Robert and Roberts commercial.
They are anti-war and pro-free market. Banks drive wars. Why use their money? Invest in silver, gold, and Bitcoin.
Angel Clark's doing the voiceover for this. I've never heard this one.
When you're serious about precious metals, shop Roberts and Roberts online at rrbi.co. That's rrbi.co.
Digging the music. I love the music to this. That's awesome.
This is your Roberts and Roberts.
I kind of want to change some of the music I want to change some of the bumpers to like some house music.
We should get some sick beats.
I know, we can get Marcus to make us like some tracks.
Bitcoin is trading at $330 US dollars. Roberts and Roberts Brokerage is a trusted name in precious metals.
Am I bringing back the last segment?
We're serious about precious metals. Give us a call at
800. Talk about sharing, I guess. Or what else you want to hit up?
Or visit us online at rrbi.co.
Why do you have like three screens up right now? Why are you looking at
between the LOL cats, the recipes,
the
hot
girls, the inspirational sunrise memes, free talk lives post, pass by your newsfeed, like them, comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas.
We're talking to the mic. I have my headphones on. I can't hear you if you're not talking to the mic.
Click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The American robin heralds the beginning of spring in temperate climates across North America. Its red breast makes it easily identifiable as the most disturbingly efficient murderer in the animal kingdom. here, we see a robin rip a worm out of the ground with no moral hesitation whatsoever. This atrocity is one of a series of cold-blooded murders that will commit in a single...
Is it up?
No. Still
awaiting rights. You want to talk about that a little bit? Or do you already kind of did, right?
I don't want to really go into it.
Yeah, time, actually. Okay.
No, it's proven. Yeah.
Okay.
I want to announce it when they can go buy it.
I gotcha. Okay.
Robins could satiate themselves on fractions or download it for free on Audible.
And leave the rest. But it does not. Unequivocal. Of the Robin's bloodlust.
This is the Onion News Network.
That you found the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
I can bring it back.
I forget. I don't mind bringing it back. No, it is my turn. I'll bring it back.
Okay.
You'll find resources at promote.lrn.fm, including details on how to get a free bumper sticker, quarter-page flyers you can print out and distribute, banners for your website, as well as files that will allow you to make your own custom banners and graphics. Visit promote.lrn.fm and help bring new listeners to the Liberty Radio Network. That's promote.lrn.fm.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include
That's
FTL
cute.
In the order notes and save 5% on your order.
While our satellite channel
the
is
baby
free,
to daddy
to,
dancing.
It's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip in on the right side of the
Facebook
page
videos.
At LRN.
Oh, what the hell is that? And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And here at the last segment of the night, I want to bring up Shire Sharing. It's literally this weekend. For those not in the know, Shire Sharing is this voluntarist charity that Amanda Bolden, the foundress, organizes every year in honor of her her father who passed away, because her father used to do this as well. The whole goal of the charity... And also, Amanda's a state rep, which is also badass. But,
is she still?
Yeah, she's still a state rep.
How long do people stay state reps?
2 years.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's a private charity, so important.
Yeah, it's a private voluntarist charity. So if you really believe in voluntarism and freedom and liberty and all that jazz, and you want to see a charity in action that of people who believe that as well, donate to this. The beauty of this charity is they basically collect as much funds as they can. No one makes a dime off of it. All the funds made in this charity go straight to buying food, basically Thanksgiving dinners.
Oh, and also
for needy families all across New Hampshire.
If you want to look up Shire Sharing, you can volunteer, because they do need people. Well, I don't even. They probably have enough volunteers, but who knows? You never know. If you're around and you want to help out, they do look for people to help assemble the bags, and I think they're doing that this Saturday.
Yeah.
So go try to check that out if that's something that you'd be interested in.
Yeah, so Shire Sharing, the goal is this year to feed 500 families, mostly around Manchester and Concord, but throughout New Hampshire. And Saturday...
Oh, I just see OMG, I can't stress enough how much we need volunteers. So yes, definitely go buy your
volunteer.
ShireSharing.org/...
just ShireSharing.org, yeah. Go find it. Cool thing also with Shire Sharing is they accept Bitcoin. I've already donated some Bitcoin to Shire Sharing. I know a lot of other people have... So it's a charity that accepts Bitcoin. They're local here in New Hampshire. They're run by voluntarists. And it's a great cause. And it's amazing to see so many people within the community come together. Both me and Aaron here, we did it last year. It was an amazing moment. I know you weren't able to do it on that Saturday. I did the Saturday, but we both did
it
Sunday.
I want to do both days
this year.
Oh,
we're definitely doing both days this year.
Okay.
Well, actually, I requested
days.
Off work to be there, so I normally can never get those days off, but I got them off.
I feel like this has been like the star voluntarist charity, and that's why I just want to try to donate to it as much as possible. It's great to show that if we have private charity, it's just showing even more. We don't need them. We don't need their hand. They're free. Trust me, they're not free handouts. People who are generous and just kind will, you know, donate to these charities, and Amanda's getting it all done through donations, not, you know, by stealing money.
Yeah. And on top of that, it's beautiful to see, again, like, you're, if this, you know, everyone always says, if the state doesn't exist, like, who, how are we going to take care of the needy and stuff like that? And this is a perfect example showing that, like, good ideas don't require force, that, you know, charities don't even need permission to be a charity or anything like that, that people can come together and help feed the needy. And we'll both be there. I'll take, I love the document stuff. If you haven't noticed, I always take video and photos wherever I go.
I wonder if they're going to be like a documentary crew. Cause that, well, you, maybe you should live stream. It was Facebook.
I don't need a live stream. Yeah. Facebook was their doc. There's a Facebook made a documentary about it last year, which is pretty cool. Really, I didn't actually watch it though, but they did make one.
I really enjoyed it last year. It felt very like community oriented. I mean, Thanksgiving is coming up, all these holidays. Like, I feel like this is my favorite time, usually because there was no school, and now, I don't know, I just feel like I like those memories. I remember doing Shire Sharing with you.
Well, I also remember November being the month we got back together.
Yeah, that was a good month.
November was a great month. Yeah.
But I feel like we just have so much going on. It's going to just fly, but it's going to be here in 2 seconds.
I mean,
and Rob's having a birthday. He's getting old.
Don't remind me.
Yay. I'm
way too old. Yeah.
What if you could do one thing for which birthday? You have to celebrate one of your birthdays, like heart.
I love how not only do you know I have two birthdays, like, but actually you know, understand what that means.
Yes. I get it. But
they're both on the same date. Not the same date. Well, the day itself, the day of the month is actually the same days, which is really weird.
Well, I mean, I feel like you should celebrate hardcore when you're like 40 or something and just have like a giant orgy in Vegas.
Why do we gotta wait till then? Let's do that now. Like,
okay,
this sounds amazing.
Let's go.
Let's just go to Vegas and have a huge orgy.
Next week.
Yes.
Meet us there.
I'm down. You can fly us out there. We'll do it.
Definitely. And then we'll use that as
Bitcoin
our bumper.
Bitcoin ballers out there that want to be beneficiaries to a orgy in Vegas.
Wow. We can just use it as an excuse to have a Bitcoin conference. Orgies for Liberty.
I wonder how many orgies happen at Bitcoin conferences.
Oh,
I'm sure
God.
They're freaky deaky.
Okay. So speaking of cover photo activism, I feel like we're missing Students for Liberty because we haven't checked that out. Is that happening? Doesn't that happen before Liberty Forum?
I think it might be like a week before Liberty Forum. I'm looking at the schedule.
No, it was like in...
Liberty Forum this year is the third week of February. All right. Last year, ISFLC was on February 14th. It was on Valentine's Day. It literally would be the week before Liberty Forum this year. I don't know if I can swing going to both. But I got to see exactly when it is. It might be on a different day. If it is, that's awesome. But it might be a little bit too close for me to get
some days off.
I don't want to take away from taking off a pork fest
really
or honeymoon.
I don't not going to Liberty Forum. I mean, to whatever, ISFLC. Like, good luck to everyone who goes. It was great. It was a great experience for that one time. But Liberty Forum's obviously more important.
And we'll be recording there, by the way.
We'll be recording once.
Oh, I didn't even tell you. Saturday, 2 o'clock at... Liberty Forum, we will be recording live the Rebel Love Show.
Oh, they gave you the schedule.
I talked to Ian earlier. No, I talked to Ian. I said, like, when can we record? And he says, I was doing Saturday.
Awesome.
So I like the fact that two of Saturdays and most of Liberty Forum had already happened, so we can really talk
about
it. And
Friday, I can get super drunk because I only have to wake up at 2.
Well, we're not.
By 2?
No, you got to wake up by, like, you know, noon or 1. Not the start of the show, like, wake up, like, welcome to the Rebel Love Show.
I've done this show drunk as fuck. I've done this show, like, sick off brownies.
You are a trooper. There are multiple times that you really muscled through a show. I'll give you that much. Yeah, you muscled through a couple times.
Hopefully at Liberty Forum, they'll be having the RLS party. Which will be really great and fun. We have great ideas. We'd have a professional DJ, all the decorations, and just make it a classy event.
It is in the planning phases.
So, I mean, I feel like we have a lot going on in the next couple of weeks, and who knows?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. I mean, I just want a reason for like a dance party. Like, I feel as if every single every single Liberty event should have like a crazy dance party like that. I just assume that now for Liberty events. Maybe I'm just spoiled by Porkfest and Keenvention.
Well, it doesn't have to be crazy. It could just be any social interaction.
Like,
people need social interaction. It doesn't have to be wild and on every single, I'm literally at the point where light switches. But like,
if MDMA and Bill Domenico's laser is not involved, is not a Liberty event I want to go to. That's literally
maybe
what I'm
doing. That's why people don't want you to have their parties. Like, they're like, no. No.
How can you be against those two things? Those two things are incredible.
There's a time and a place.
And yeah, no time and places are at Liberty events. I mean, maybe more people would go to these things if, I don't know, maybe more people would be in Liberty if there's more parties.
Yeah, I think, like, I'm thinking cupcakes and punch.
Cupcakes and punch.
Yeah.
At a party for Liberty. Yeah. We're living free, and we gotta show how free we are. I want the Liberty movement to be like as big as like the. I want the Liberty movement to be bigger and cooler than all the people that go to Burning Man. That's what I want to see the Liberty movement to be.
Yeah, but one festival. They can't just do that at every festival. What if Burning Man happened like 18 times? People would be like, I'm sick of Burning Man. But anyway, I mean, it's been a pretty good couple weeks, and we got some more stuff coming up. And like I said, my audiobook will be coming out, and I'm talking it up, but I'm not saying much about it because I'm waiting for it to be finalized and finished, and then you can go download it for free. On Audible, so don't sign up now. Sign up when it comes out, which should be by the next show. It'll definitely be out.
I'm sure it will.
No, I'm sure it will. Like, literally, I'm waiting on one click, and then that's it. So I'm really excited for that, and my new career as a voice actress. And, you know...
You're gonna be one of the shining stars.
Yeah, I'm doing books on BDSM and Revolution. I think
how badass is that?
You want to see, you know, what kind of mistress I really can be, you know, I have a sweet side, but I also have another side as well. So don't be fooled. what were you gonna
say? I'm excited about it. I want to listen to the whole thing.
You're listening to the whole thing.
The tips.
I hope you jerk off.
Oh, I will. Trust
where
me.
Can we find you?
Oh, where can we find me?
Yeah.
I'm at the Rebel Love Show. I'm at rebelloveshow.com.
Me as well. And also go like the Rebel Mistress on Facebook.
Peace, guys.